Captain Intrigue here. In this episode, I'll be building a stun glove. So what is a stun glove exactly? A stun glove generates a high voltage electric discharge across your knuckles so that when you punch someone, it stuns them. I've actually built quite a few of these over the years, but I wanted to try something different this time. I want to build a modular system so that I can easily swap the glove out depending on the weather conditions outside. So for example, in the summer, I could wear a thin fingerless tactical glove. And in the winter, I could wear more of a winter glove so my hands don't get cold. So this is actually the glove that I decided on. It's actually considered a tactical winter glove. And I like it because it has this large cuff area so I can attach components to. And my plan is to build a stretchable fabric sleeve that slides over the glove that contains all the components. And that way, when I'm ready to switch the glove, I just pull all that off and put a different glove underneath it.
So there are five main components to the stun glove design that I'm building. The first component is the electrode assembly. The electrode assembly needs to be made from non-conductive material, and that includes non-conductive screws. Anything electrically conductive that's attached to the output electrodes could potentially cause high voltage arcing and can even zap your hand right through the glove. So it's very important to design and build this part correctly. The next component is the high voltage module, which is one that I bought on Amazon since it's fairly cheap. It's also small and ready to go as is. They typically run on 3 to 12 volts DC and cost under $10. It's possible to actually increase the voltage up to 12 volts, which allows you to strike a much longer arc, but that causes these high voltage modules to burn out pretty fast, and so it's best to keep it around 5 volts DC. The next component is the voltage regulator, which is a 5 volt, 3 amp servo power regulator typically used on RC planes. It's small, cheap, and won't overdrive the high voltage module since it puts out a steady 5 volts DC. The next part is the power source, which is a 1000 milliamp lithium ion battery pack rated at 20C, which means it's capable of putting out around 20 amps for very short durations. That's good because the high voltage module can draw up to 3 amps when it first fires. And then the final component is the switch, which will be used to activate the stun glove. Now let's take a look at some CAD design. Okay, this is the electrode assembly that'll be mounted on top of the glove. This is where I'll be mounting the electrodes to. And this is a strain relief that's going to be used to hold the high voltage wires. And this is the fire button that will attach to the thumb, and a momentary switch will be inserted in here used to trigger the stun glove. And now it's time to 3D print the parts on the maker gear.
Alright, so here are all the parts for the stun glove. This is the glove. This is gonna go there. This is for the thumb. And that's the strain relief. Here's the battery pack, high voltage module, the voltage regulator, the push button switch, which is gonna go in here. And then this is special high voltage wire. It's high voltage silicon wire. And this stuff is essential. You can't just run normal wiring from the output of this high voltage module, or if you do, it'll start arcing. You have to use special wire. This is sort of special wire, but this is the good stuff. It's pretty much guaranteed that you won't have arcing out of the wire. So I'll run that from here down into this area. And then the plan is to mount all of these things kind of down here somehow. And got all this different elastic band webbing. It's stretchable, so I'm gonna try to sew up some kind of like webbing structure that goes over the top of this glove. All right, so here's what I've come up with. I've kind of sewed this thing with some little pouches here. It's all stretchable, so I can insert the high voltage module in here, the battery in here, and there's a little pouch here for the regulator. And then this is just gonna go over this cuff. And then I've got this stretchable piece that's gonna go attached to the electrode assembly and go around the palm, kinda like this. And I've got some holes, I just burned holes through there with the soldering iron. And then this is gonna connect here. So I'll get all this connected together and show you how it's gonna look. All right, here's the hand module. So what I did, I attached this webbing here and more of this thin webbing for the fingers. And then I've got one here. So the way this goes on, like this. And then this one goes over that finger. And then the thumb is used to hit the trigger switch. All right, in the electrode assembly, I'm using these nylon screws. That way I won't have any kind of conduction going through the thickness of this plate that could potentially zap me through the glove. So the only thing metallic are these washers, and I'll slip the wires underneath those and tighten them down. So that part's done, and I've got this all wired up. Just like in the diagram, this is the output. This is the high voltage module. This is the input, and this is the regulator, which generates 5 volts DC. And then I just put a connector on the end of it so I can plug the battery in. And these two wires here are gonna be for the trigger switch, which I'll wire in. So now I'll put this into the sleeve and sort of get it assembled. All right, so I've inserted the high voltage module into here. And the electrodes wires come out here. Got these spliced on already. This is the regulator. It's just gonna tuck into this little pouch. And then these are the push button switch wires. Gonna feed these through. Okay, and then I'll put the battery into here. Okay, just like that. And then this will connect to here once we're ready to power it up. Okay, so now I need to install this on the glove. I need to wire up this push button switch. And get these wires connected. Let's do that, I guess. Alright, so there's the electrodes connected up. It's okay to use conductive screws here because these are far enough away. What's important is to use non-conductive screws in this spot right there. And it'll strike the arc right between those two points. Okay, I just need to solder this wire. I'm actually gonna route it through here. Made that hole just for that. Alright, and then I'll solder that to the switch carefully, and then I can put it all together and test it.
Alright, that's it. All finished, put together. Just test it out here. So that's it. How to build a stun glove. Very simple.
You?
I'm Captain Intrigue. I can help you, Katie.
So how are you feeling?
Better.
Okay, good. I'll be outside when you're ready.
Okay.